Hey guys, today I'm going to be talking about creating a Docker image from scratch. What that essentially means is you create an absolutely empty image. There is nothing that already exists on it, for example, an operating system or anything. Whatever you add onto this image would be the first layer of the file system. Why would you want to do that? There are two main use cases. One is if you want to create your own base image to distribute to other people to use. The other is if you have a self-contained application binary, and you just want to pack it inside a Docker image and run a super, super lightweight container in production or anywhere else. That's a very important use case. So let's dive right into it. I am in my workspace and I'm going to be using Golang for this. I've written a very simple application which prints hello world and then goes into an infinite loop so that our program does not end immediately and we can actually see our container running. Let's go create a Docker file for this. And this is the main part where you'd normally write from Alpine, from Ubuntu, or something similar to use a base image. Here, you'd write from scratch. Scratch is a reserved word in Docker, which tells Docker that this is an absolutely clean slate, right? Just do what I tell you, just add what I tell you, and there is nothing else on this image. So I want to add my executable and then just run my executable. There, simple. Now let's go ahead and actually build an executable. Notice that we have built our executable for the Linux platform. The reason is because all Docker containers essentially run on top of Linux. So even if, for example, you're using Mac or Windows, Docker is actually running a Linux virtual machine underlying and then running the containers on top of them. So we have a binary, we have everything. Let's go ahead and build. And let's call this image hello. That was quick. Let's see if we have our image there. So we have our Docker image called hello, and for a comparison, we can see how lightweight it really is compared to any of the other common images, for example, Ubuntu or even Alpine, which is one of the lightest images out there. Because the only major size of our image is just our own executable, and that's the only thing that exists inside it. So let's run it. And this is working as we expected. We are now running a container which contains nothing except for our own executable application, and now the app is running. And there's my container. Fun fact, if I want to, for example, execute a shell inside this container just to try and examine it, I cannot do any of those things because remember that the only thing that does exist inside my container is my own Hello World application. And so there is no shell program like Bash to execute inside it. Yep, that's all for this one, and hope you enjoyed it. Feel free to leave some feedback.